Hello, everybody. Welcome to Fridays with Roz, with your girl Roz. I'm very excited to be here again for Fridays. Let me just make sure, listen, everything else that you guys are doing, make sure that it is on airplane mode, so that way you don't get distracted from your girl Roz. So, we're all on airplane mode. Let's make sure that we're there. All right, guys. Welcome to Fridays with Roz. I see Michael Ormsby. Hey, Michael. Yes, I see your hey there, Roz. Every Friday, I'm doing a little bit of a series. So if you guys happen to be here last week, I happen to do the wonderful, wonderful music of Etta James. And so each week, other than next week, I'll be traveling out west, back from the Midwest, from where I've been staying the last few weeks. And so I won't be on next Friday, but I'll be all through July, every Friday at this time, and I'll be bringing you some new tunes. And, you know, I thought that the music that I want to bring you guys every week, it's also fun for me to do, to see how many different genres that the Satin Dolls can master. So, last week I started with the lovely Etta James, and this week I'm going to continue the iconic women of musical genius with Miss Rosemary Clooney and Miss Ella Fitzgerald. I've always said that if I could be recreated by any two people, or I guess three between last week and this week, it would be Miss Rosemary Clooney, Miss Ella Fitzgerald, and Miss Etta James. So you throw all those three women together, and it's who I strive to be. And if I had a dinner, you know, if they ask you, who would you have dinner with? You know, five, top five. And I want you guys to respond here, too. If you guys had a choice of the top five people of any time period, who would you love to have dinner with? And I can tell you that mine would absolutely, my number one, would be Rosemary Clooney, because she's the epitome of being wonderful and being a woman and being strong. And so, yes, she'd be my number one dinner date. So tell me who would you guys invite to your dinner around your table? Martin Smithson, yes. Yes, I am well. I hope that everybody out there is keeping up with wearing your masks. We are in a pandemic in the midst of all the crazy that's going on. We are still in a pandemic, so please care about each other and just wear a mask. It means that I care about you from afar, from 6 feet afar. So definitely wear your masks, guys, and stay, you know, washing your hands and all of that. Lori Bittinger, I see you. How are you watching me? I believe this is a woman that I know very near and dear to my heart, and she's supposed to be working right now. Or maybe it's your lunch break. Actually, I think she's on lunch right now, so these shows are perfect for her. Tony Dark. Tony, I have to say, last week I pronounced your last name wrong a couple of times, and I am so thankful that you're so gracious and you did correct me. It's not Tony Drake, although that's a great stage name. It's Tony Dark. So thank you, Tony. Thank you so much. Kyle Forrest. Oh, FDR. Kyle Forrest would invite FDR to his dinner party. I mean, I love that as well. Michael Ormsby, Martin Luther King Jr. Can you imagine what Martin Luther King Jr. would have to say during these times right now? He'd either be incredibly for it, which I think he actually would be, because it's finally changing in the world, and we're finally taking this huge stand that he wanted to take. But I think he would be like, we just need to see eye to eye and be equal. So yes, that's a great one. E1, greetings. Hello, E1. Adrian Burgess, I believe it's Burgess. Good afternoon to you too. Tony, I get it all the time. It's just, you know, you should just change it. Tony Drake is just, it's a great name for you. Just change it. No, I'm just kidding. When you walk around in life, people are going to say, why'd you change your name? And you're going to say, oh, Roz of the Satin Dolls told me to change it. And so I said, yeah, let's do it. Tony, yes, also Sinatra, Crosby, and Elvis. Ooh, can you imagine that jam session at your dinner table if you could get all of those guys together? You know, back when Sinatra, Crosby, and Elvis were around, they didn't necessarily like the idea of collaborating on things with other huge stars because they wanted, you know, to have the limelight themselves. So, man, that would have been a great mashup if we would have had them. So, all right. I thought we would get to my first song of the afternoon, evening. I know everyone out there in the UK, if you're watching, it is in the evening and you are getting ready to stay in, or you're just getting ready to have a night and you want Miss Roz to entertain you with some music in the background while you get ready. All right, so you know this first tune. We're going to kick it off right, guys. So here we go. Let's invite everyone in. Come on to my house, to my house. I'm gonna give you candy. Come on to my house, to my house. I'm gonna give you apple and a plum and an apricot or two. Come on to my house, and come on. Come on to my house, and come on. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you figs and dates and grapes and cakes, yeah. Come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, come on. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you candy. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you everything. That's right. For those of you just joining, Fridays with Roz. Come on to my house. That's right. Woo! Come on to my house, come on. I'm gonna give you a Christmas tree. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you marriage ring and a pomegranate too. Come on to my house, and come on. Come on to my house, and come on. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you peach and a pear. Do you love my hair? Yeah. Come on to my house, and come on. Come on to my house, and come on. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you the egg. Come on to my house, I'm gonna give you everything, everything, everything. Come on to my house. Woo! All right. Well, I thought that we would just start the day with inviting you all into, well, literally into my home. We are at my parents' home in Oklahoma. So for those of you who don't know, I'm a country girl at heart. You can't take the country out the girl. So this is where I was raised, in Oklahoma. And then I headed out west to see what I could take over, which is the world. And we'll all do it together, especially the Satin Dolls, because we're already doing that. We're already conquering the world. And we're in London, we're in Paris, so, you know, it starts there. You know, it's always that. You start in Europe, and then you become a big hit in the States, and so we have to go over there to come back over here. And actually, we went over there. We have a song out on the jazz charts in the UK on iTunes, and our producer, maybe if the Satin Dolls could answer this question, how are we doing on that song? Where is it dropped at right now in the UK? We know that it's done really well, and for that we are incredibly grateful. It's called That Man, and it's a cover of Carl Emerald's song, That Man. Has a little bit of a mashup in there, but you guys will, if you know it or have heard it, please, please, please share with your friends and have them go on and buy the record and help us get to the top, because that's where we're all going. All right. Let's see who we have on here. Oh, Moshi? Ooh, I might be saying that wrong. From Israel. I really, 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 really hope that you're from Israel. I have got to say, being Iranian, being from the Middle East, I just want to say Chene du Setarem, and that it means I love you. And you are my people. So thank you. Thank you for signing on and being from Israel. I don't know if that's the first one from Israel that we've had. But thank you so much for being on here. It makes me so happy. Daniel Euler, thank you, my dear friend. Mama Mia, that's some good singing. Thank you, Michael. It's going to get better. It's going to get much better. The songs are tailored to you all. So let's see. Oh, I love it. Gotta run. Love you all. That's from a very special person near and dear to my heart. And were you living near Olivia? Martin Smithson. Ooh, you know your Satin Doll trivia. You know that Miss Olivia, she also hails from the great state of Oklahoma. No, I didn't live very close to Miss Olivia. We're both from small towns in opposite directions. She's more north, northeast, I believe, from me. But I have actually been to her hometown. We actually did a concert there last fall, and it was an amazing weekend. Her father is this amazing, amazing man who has this gorgeous venue and theater in town, and it was a wonderful time, and so I enjoyed her small town. So one of these days, we'll get down to my hometown, and then all the Satin Dolls will come in, and we'll do a show from here. Okay, so that man, unfortunately, it's not on the charts anymore, but it's available on Spotify, on Apple Music, on iTunes. Please, please, please go take a listen. You do not want to miss it. So definitely hit that record up. It's That Man by us, yours truly. And we wrote all the harmonies on it and threw in a mashup. And it's wonderful. Lance Alexander Files. Well, that is a great long name. I love that. Hello from Lake Arrowhead. Well, do you have a cabin out there? This is just water, by the way. Your girl Roz drinks water. Lake Arrowhead is wonderful. Let's see. E1. Maybe I should start playing it more then. Yes, you should start playing it more. Let's get on that man record. Get it played more, guys. Oh, I see another person that I know, very near and dear to my heart, Miss Vicky Blake. Hello from Oklahoma City. I'm so glad that people in Oklahoma City are watching this, because I'm in a different time zone than everyone in LA and everyone in the UK. So we got all kinds of time zones here going on. And my favorite is on here as well. Thank you, Miss Jennifer Rizzo. You are my favorite. And man, we have lots of friends on here today. I'm so happy. So why don't we get into another tune? So like I said, Miss Rosemary Clooney had to start us off with Come On To My House, because you guys are in my house now. So let's all get cozy. Let's all get a drink. It's hot in Oklahoma, so you probably don't want a hot drink. You probably just want yourself a sweet tea. So grab yourself a sweet tea. If you can go outside, sit under a tree. This next tune is by Miss Ella Fitzgerald. I'm going to slow it down just a little bit. Do a little love song for that. Bye.
and lost in a sigh, were we the shore was kissed by sea and mist tenderly. I can't forget how two hearts met breathlessly. Your arms opened wide and closed me inside. You took my lips, you took my love so tenderly. Your arms opened wide and closed me inside. You took my lips, you took my love so.
A wonderful song, tenderly. So I don't know if you grabbed your sweet tea or grabbed your loved one. Those of you that are out there and just need a little way to say to somebody how much you love them and how much you care, but you don't quite have the words to say it, any one of these songs from this era will do. I promise you that. I promise you that. All right. We have one of my favorite people on today, the Gingerbread Men. The Gingerbread Men say hello to our to our official gingerbread doll. Oh my goodness gracious. You have no idea what an honor that is to be called your gingerbread doll. If you guys don't know, the Satin Dolls love to collaborate with other artists that are out there. And I had the wonderful opportunity to collaborate with the talented and amazing Gingerbread Men up in Canada, if you can believe it. Four men up there just singing away in perfect four-part harmony. And we did a cover of Santa Baby in the middle of summer because, you know, when the pandemic started, it was a little crazy. So we felt like, why not do a Christmas song in the middle of summer? You know, maybe I'll do one. Maybe I'll do one today. I wasn't planning on it, but I do one song that maybe if I can find the song for it, you know, in this, I can sing it for you guys. But yes, go on YouTube, find the Gingerbread Men and the Satin Dolls. It's called Santa Baby, and it's just a good time. You know, definitely will get you guys ready for the holidays well before the holidays. I know if I could have it my way, I would have my Christmas tree up year-round. I actually do have twinkle lights up year-round, so, you know, there's that. Oh, thank you, Tony. I appreciate that. Ella Fitzgerald is, I mean, she's just an amazing female artist, and she just inspires me so much in what I do, and I know, and well, I think most singers who have that soulful kind of vibe, they it all starts with women like Ella Fitzgerald, and she's the queen. Christopher Register, thank you so much, my friend. Jeffrey Victor, I appreciate you, sir. We should do another collaboration with the Satin Dolls sometime soon. Thank you. I think this is, think it's Moshi or Moshi. I know I'm pronouncing it wrong. I'm going to say Moshi, but just know that it's because I love you. He says, you're an angel and your voice is beautiful. Well, you know, I know that we need love during this time, but we especially need love and kindness in the Middle East and in Israel, because it's the greatest little city in the world, but there's definitely a lot of turmoil there. So definitely, if you guys have prayers up for my people out in Israel. Okay, so we were saying earlier, for those of you who just got on, if you could pick anyone, anytime era, to come and sit at your dinner table and have a conversation and play games. I would love to play games with Ella Fitzgerald and Rosemary Clooney. I want to see how they would respond. But who else would you like to have sit at your dinner table? I want to kick it to a contemporary time and say I would love to have J-Lo sit at my table. I would. I love her. She's an icon and she is an empire, and it's lovely to see such a force. So, I see Miss Desiree J is on. Yes, Miss Marilyn. I think that we all would like to see Miss Marilyn Monroe at your dinner table. Like, what would she be like? You know, she would be down to play games. She would be, she'd enjoy it so much. Let's see here. Thank you all so much. Thank you, Michael. I appreciate it so much. Okay. So who else? Who else, guys? Who else would you love to have at your dinner table? That's the question of the hour, is who you would love to have sitting with you. It can be anyone. They can be passed on. E1, I see you. They don't have to be living. They could have been from years and years ago. So you guys tell me who you would like to see. All right. Well, definitely have some more songs for you all. Let me see what else I got in my pouch. Oh! All right. Well, we're going to kick things back up a little bit. So, if you all are ready, I'm going to go back to my girl Roz, but we're going to go back to my girl Rosemary Clooney for this next tune. It's called Mambo Italiano. Here we go. A girl went back to Napoli because she missed the scenery, the native dances and the charming songs. But wait a minute, something's wrong. Hey, Mambo, Mambo Italiano. Hey, Mambo, Mambo Italiano. Go, go, go. You mixed up Siciliano. All you Calabrese do the mambo like a crazy when you. Hey, Mambo, don't wanna tell and tell her. Hey, Mambo, no more mozzarella. Hey, Mambo, Mambo Italiano. Try an enchilada with a fishy bacala. And hey, you there, I love how you dance rumba. But take some advice, my girl, oh, learn how to mambo. If you're gonna be a square, you ain't gonna wear a. Hey, Mambo, Mambo Italiano. Hey, Mambo, Mambo Italiano. Go, go, Joe, shake it like a Giovanni. Hello, quesadilla, you get happy in the pizza when you mambo Italiano. Shake it, baby, shake it, cause I love it when you take me. Woo! Mama say you stop it, or I'm gonna tell your papa and I. Hey, you there, you don't have to go to school. Just make it with a beat bambino, it's like a vino. Get you a good looking, but you don't know what is cooking. So you, hey, Mambo, Mambo Italiano. Hey, Mambo, Mambo Italiano. Ho, ho, ho. you mixed up Siciliano. Pizza so delicious, everybody can capisce when you mumble Italiano. That's a nice. It's so much fun. Woo! Mambo Italiano just is wonderful. I have a feeling that the Satin Dolls producer might love that I just did that song. Let's see what we have here. Oh, E1 for me would be John Cage. It's a good one. John Cage. Michael Ornsby. I think all the dolls, both U.S. and U.K., would have dinner with Jay Gatsby, especially after the Gatsby stream a few weeks ago. Michael, you are absolutely correct. I mean, not only would I have dinner with Jay Gatsby, but I would get him to put a ring on my finger. All the single ladies, get that ring on it. You know what I'm saying? Yes, I would have Jay Gatsby at my dinner party. For sure. Moshi says, come visit Tel Aviv. I'm a little taken aback. Lola, I don't know. I mean, I know you're watching, but you've got to tell me, is Israel it's the only Middle Eastern country that I think has been on these. I don't know if it's been the only Middle Eastern country, but I'm a little taken aback that we're reaching Israel, and this is amazing. This is amazing, and this is one of the reasons that we do what we do, is to reach the ends of the earth, and I'm incredibly grateful that we're reaching you in Tel Aviv. We love your voice. That's very, very sweet of you. Follow me, guys, on Instagram. You guys can go to my Instagram, follow me. It's roslyn.rogers, and follow me there. You'll see all of our Satin Dolls latest videos. You can also, you know, go to the Satin Dolls Facebook page, like it. Go to the Instagram, like it, follow. You will see all of the dolls, and we hope we can bring you more beautiful voices to Israel. I know that we all need it around the world right now. Ah, bellissima! Fridays. Oh, hashtag Fridays with Roz. Oh, I don't know. Maybe we just started a new hashtag, Lola. Hashtag Fridays with Roz. I'll take it. I'll start using it. Jonathan Hall, oh, amazing as usual. Thank you so much. Yes, the Satin Dolls, we reach all countries who want to watch. So my friend Moshi in Israel, if you have friends that have Facebook, please, by all means, share with them the Satin Dolls page and my live stream. As most of you all know, and Moshi, you might not know this, but I'm Iranian. And I'm incredibly grateful for my culture and being from the Middle East. I'm very proud to be an Iranian-American. My father is Iranian, and he came here back in the late 1970s, early 80s. And he met my mother, who's Native American, English. She's got European. She's very European. But they got together, and I was raised in a Persian home, and I'm incredibly grateful for it. And being from that part of the world. So if you have friends over there in Israel or in any countries that are around you, tell them to, you know, follow the Satin Dolls. And who knows, maybe one day we'll do a concert in Tel Aviv. I'm speechless just thinking about it. That would be amazing. And I wouldn't bat an eye. I would absolutely come out there. Yes, E1... For someone living, it would be artist Laurie Anderson. Okay, she's had a major impact on your life since your teens. You know, I'll have to check her out. I don't know who Laurie Anderson is, so thank you. This is also a good platform for people to share, you know, artists and people that we don't know and we can get to know a little bit better. So, okay, everybody. So I wanted to share with you one of my little secrets as a singer. Now, of course, you have to stay hydrated, but also I have a little trick that I use right before I sing. So I want to know if you, for any of you singers out there or any of you performers out there that are watching, What are some pre-show rituals that you do, and share them here, because I'm curious. I haven't met anybody yet, other than one person who introduced it to me. What I do before I sing, and if I am feeling a little parched, I grab these little things. These little things called Lay's potato chips. So we eat those Lay's potato chips. Don't get it on your dress. My producer would kill me. And I call it my vocal WD-40. That's what I call it. Because it helps get all the stuff down. And it helps you sing songs like Rosemary Clooney, and she does it so easily. So that's my trick. So I'll share that with any singer, any performer. Get yourself some Lay's potato chips. Yes, product placement. Get yourself some Lay's potato chips today, and you too could sing like Roz. That would be my product placement. Oh yes, product placement. Yes, the satin dolls. We should just screenshot this right now. And I'm just like, oh, like this. I hope you screenshot that. Send that to Lay's potato chips and tell them that's how the satin dolls get ready for their shows. Trust me, I share them with the girls and they all partake. Oh yes, another hashtag, Fry Lay's with Roz. I will take it. Take all of these hashtags. Actually, give me your best Roz hashtags for Fry Lay's with Roz. I would love to see what you all come up with. You never know, one of your hashtags might show up on the next live streams. Yes, intended or not, if it works, yes. Okay, so this next song that I'm going to do for you all is the song that made me fall in love with Rosemary Clooney, and it made me so enamored by her and her voice, and you might be able to guess what it is. Do I have any guesses out there before I play it? What's a song that Rosemary Clooney might sing that is incredibly inspiring to me? It actually is the most inspiring Rosemary Clooney song that I know. So, I'm going to take a tiny little sip. And let's see if you guys know it. You do. You know it. All right, here we go. Shelf, and I'm blaming myself, but it's you. My one love affair didn't get anywhere from the start. To send me a Joe who had winter and snow in his heart wasn't smart, Lord. As they say in the song, you done me wrong. My one love affair didn't get anywhere from the start. Send me a Joe who had winter and snow in his heart wasn't smart. Oh, love, you didn't do right by me, as they say in the song.
done me wrong. Yes, Mr. Love, you done me wrong. Oh.
How can you not love that song? How can you not love Rosemary Clooney, in the movie White Christmas? She's at the Carousel Club. She just sees Bing Crosby come through and sit down, and she gets nervous and she asks the musical director, please, let's change the song. Let's do anything else. Blue skies, anything else. I could quote the movie. And he says, no, you sounded wonderful. And she was scared to sing it because it was about Mr. Crosby. And, it just melts your heart. That is the moment that I looked and said, who is this woman? And this amazing, amazing, amazing power that she has. And so most of the time when I sing this music, I'm challenging Miss Clooney. She is definitely the one that I'm channeling. And also, yes, I see you, Lola. I see the satin dolls commenting. In fact, yes, it's actually one of my favorite tidbits about Hollywood and about Rosemary Clooney, and that the song that she sang, Love, You Didn't Do Right By Me, it featured an amazing dancer, and his name is George Chakiris. And if you don't know who George is, you need to go back and watch West Side Story all over again, because George Chakiris is he's the lead, one of the lead dancers in the song Love, You Didn't Do Right By Me, and he has this amazing moment with her that his back is to the audience and he turns to the camera and he's standing like this and you see his beautiful face and his cleft in his chin, and he's amazing. And then, of course, he went on to then do, I believe he was a contract player at that point for the production house that did White Christmas. And so that became the next picture, which was West Side Story. He was Bernardo, who is my everything. He will always be my Bernardo, and I will always be his Anita. That's a dream role of mine to play, is Anita in West Side Story. And, Actually, he's also in Diamonds Are a Girl's Best Friend with Marilyn Monroe. So you had your boy George, he was working it on the dance thing, and he's an amazing dancer. And actually, the Satin Dolls had the amazing opportunity to meet him this last Christmas at the amazing 1940s Christmas Ball in Denver, Colorado. The producer and showrunner, Kinsey, of the 1940s Ball, she was amazing and brought him there, and the Satin Dolls got to meet him. I unfortunately did not get to meet him because your girl Roz, before Christmas, before Thanksgiving, 2 days before Thanksgiving, I was actually in a pretty bad car accident, and I broke my collarbone, which, as you can see, she's better, praise. But it was not even 2 weeks before the show that we were slated to do in Colorado at the 1940s Christmas Ball. And so I unfortunately had to miss it. And I miss George! So mad! Yes, he got to spend time in their car. And, I just, you know, giving love to George and that he's still with us. Because not a lot of people from this era are still with us. So it's wonderful to see that he was there and he represented this era. So I'm very much jealous that I wasn't there. Yes, so good. So good. So who else from that time was in, you know, if you all haven't seen, there's a show out right now on Netflix called Hollywood, and there's actually quite a few songs if you listen close enough, and there's actually at the end of one of the episodes, they play a song called Bounce Me Brother. And just listening to the original recording of what they did at the end of the episode really made me excited, because actually we have rearranged, the Satin Dolls have rearranged Bounce Me Brother. And it's not Bounce Me Brother 8 to the Bar. It's Bounce Me Brother. If you all could correct me on the rest of that title, I keep saying the wrong one. But it's Bounce Me Brother, and we've reinvented it. It will be on the album that I'm saying is going to be up and ready to go for Christmas presents. So be on the lookout for that. But if you watch the show Hollywood, it's a huge throwback to this time. And also, it's wonderful because they really do look at the issues that have been in Hollywood since have been the test of time. So it's wonderful to see that they're looking at those things and they're really bringing it to the forefront. So if you have a chance to go and watch Hollywood, you'll hear some Satin Dolls music that we have kind of taken and reinvented. That's kind of one of the joys of being a Satin Doll, is we are not a cover band. And it's wonderful to be able to take the music of that time and reinvent it to now, so that everyone can enjoy it of every age. And I just hearing Bouncy Brother on Hollywood, I was like, oh, we redid that song. So definitely be on the lookout for the album that's coming out. I believe most likely it'll be in the fall, and it will have Bouncy Brother on it. It will have Shoo Shoo Baby. It'll have, you know, all these wonderful tunes that they're just updated a little bit. We've taken it and redone it. So, yes, everyone who's on there, if you like our live streams, invite your friends to like our page. It's really easy. You just go to the community tab on our page and click invite friends, and then select them all. Select all your friends and tell them to come and come and join the dolls and follow us as we roll to the top. You don't want to miss it. Get in on the ground floor now, which is not really the ground floor. I think we're at like 15,000 likes, or I'm sorry, followers and whatnot. So it's amazing. So definitely do that. Yes, Bounce Me Brother with a solid 4. A little acapella sample. All right, we'll do a little acapella sample. So the beginning goes like this. Say, what kind of beat is that? Man, that really spins my head. Doesn't sound like boogie woogie, cause it's really gotta be. Seems to us that it's in 4. Let us hear it just once more. Come on and latch on to that rhythm, cause a solid 4's my meat. That is the intro. So if you like the intro, then you'll really love, then what happens is the girls come in and we do a 3-part harmony for the rest of the song, and very tight harmonies. And they're wonderful and fun and fast. And also, in case you didn't know, the tap dancers were on stage at the same time, tapping their faces off. Literally their faces off. Because they get hot, hot, hot. So, yes, definitely check that out. And I actually think there's a cartwheel. Flip your lid. Yeah, so we do this little flip your lid in the song. And when we do that little flip, the Satin Doll dancers are actually doing a cartwheel on stage in the live show. I'm telling you all, when you get a chance to see us live, don't miss it. Just don't miss it. Weddings, birthday parties, you're not always going to get a chance to see the Satin Dolls. So bring the family, and you'll have a good time. All right, we got to keep going because I have quite a few more songs. So let's see what I have next here. It disconnected from my speaker. Let me just do that, because you're going to want to hear this tune. Because now we... Let me make sure. We do this song. We've done this song in show, but you know, we've kind of put it to the side a little bit. And this is my opportunity to bring it back. So, my goal here is to see if I can convince the producer of the Sad Dolls to put it back in. Now, I selfishly want to just sing it as a solo because it's real good. But, all right, if you're ready, we're going to get in. Here we go. Now, the Sad Dolls did this once upon a time, but I've taken it and I've done a little bit of zhuzhing to it. The moves you hear vocally are from Miss Ella Fitzgerald's live version of her album Live at Zardy's. So this is where it's from. Here we go.
You had plenty money back in 22. You let other women make a fool of you. Why don't you do right like some other men do? Get out of here and get me some money too.
That's right.
You're sitting down wondering what it's all about. If you ain't got no money, they will throw you out. Why don't you do right like some other men do? Get out of here and get me some money too. Well, if you had prepared 20 years ago, you wouldn't be a wandering from now door to door. Why don't you do right like some other men do? Whoa, 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 yeah. Get out of here and get me some money too. Go and get it. Hey! Buddy-dee-dee, buddy-buddy-day, buddy-dee-dee, buddy-dee-dee.
Show. So, Lola, I'm sure you liked it. I hope you did. Got a little scouting in there. Had to bring up the soul. Yes, Miss Ella Fitzgerald has an album that if you do not have it, you must get it. It is called Live at Zardy's. And I believe it's when she was younger. And it's a wonderful album. It's something to have on when you're driving, when you're just enjoying your time at home. It's just a fantastic album to get, and I love that it's live at Zardy's. I would love to do the music of that concert because it was live. So some of what they did was improv'd and in the show, and she sings some of those wonderful songs, and she does a lot of scatting. if you want to know about scatting, she's the one that you go to. So we're just going to keep on trucking. Thank you, Tony Dart. Can't beat the classics. You can't. You can't beat the classics. Oh, Chris, sad face because I didn't know about your accident. Oh, honey, we're fine. Arms up. Let's roll. Roll out. That's how the Satin Dolls roll. You get up and you get out. Thank you, Michael. Thank you. All right, guys, we're going to keep going because I don't have much time left and I got to get to my last song. So let's see what's next, shall we? No. Oh, yes. So this song is called Blue Moon, and I actually didn't know that Ella Fitzgerald covered it. So I'd like to sing it for you.
Blue Moon, you saw me standing alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own. Blue moon, you knew just what I was there for. You heard me saying a prayer for someone I really could care for. And then there suddenly appeared before me the only one my arms would ever hold. I heard somebody whisper, please adore me. And when I looked, the moon had turned gold. Blue moon, now I'm no longer alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own. And then there suddenly appeared before me the only one my arms will ever hold. I heard somebody whisper, please adore me. And when I looked, the moon had turned gold. Blue moon, now I'm no longer alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love.
Oh, everybody loves that. It's interesting how songs we find that we don't realize how far back they go. So it was wonderful that that Ella did a cover of Blue Moon. It made me very happy because I know the faster version. I know the blue moon, you saw me standing alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own. We know it a little faster, right? By all the gents. I think actually one of my favorites is Frankie Valli. I think he did that tune with the Four Seasons. And that's how I heard it. And then, of course, all of the boy bands, I guess if you'd say, the boy groups of the 50s and 60s, they really took it over and they reinvented it. So that's the version I always knew. Okay, we might run out of time, but I'm going to go on to my next tune. This song everybody knows, so we're just going to go into it. We're going to do it raw style. The night is young, the skies are clear, and if you wanna go walking, dear, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's de-lovely. I understand the reason why you're sentimental, cause so am I. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's de-lovely. You can tell at a glance what a swell night this is. Romance, you
you can hear dear Mother Nature murmuring along. Let yourself go, so please be sweet, my chickadee. And when I kiss you, just say to me, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's delectable, it's delirious, it's dilemma, it's delimit, it's deluxe, it's lovely. You can tell at a glance what a swell night this is for romance. You can hear dear Mother Nature murmuring low. Let yourself go, so please be sweet, my chickadee. And when I kiss you, just say to me, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's delectable, it's delirious, it's dilemma, it's delimit, it's deluxe, it's lovely.
Woo! Ooh, had to turn that one up. We all love a little DeLovely. It's Cole Porter, if you don't know who that is. And I'm quite obsessed with Cole Porter. Cole Porter has many, many, many songs that many singers cover. And Ella Fitzgerald, Rosemary Clooney, Etta James, all the greats, they all covered Cole Porter because he was a gem. And of course, he went on to write many, many, many tunes for musical theater. A lot of Gilbert and Sullivan and Rodgers and Hammerstein, Rodgers and Hart, they all love him. So they used his songs in their shows. Yes, delightful and DeLovely. Thank you so much. Yes, those are two words that best describe these going on 4 months of Satin Doll live streams. So thank you so much. this is my last tune. So I want to get a song. I want to get a little sip right here. Because I want you all, in this time that we're all in, and I wanted to dedicate this song to one of my favorite Satin Dolls. They're all my favorite, let's face it. But I wanted to dedicate this song to Miss Giselle because she's an amazing singer and she is a soprano at heart. And so I just wanted to dedicate this to her because I love her. So all of my Satin Dolls, especially Miss Giselle, thank you all so much for tuning in. And again, be sure to remember, we have a 4th of July weekend live stream shows going on all weekend long. So please, please, please don't miss our show times for that. And then I will be back right here Fridays with Roz the Friday after that. So thank you all so much for tuning in. And this one is for Miss Giselle. When I'm worried and I can't sleep, I count my blessings instead of sheep, and I fall asleep counting my blessings. When my bankroll is getting low, I think of when I had none at all, and I fall asleep counting my blessings. I think about a nursery and I picture curly hair, and one by one I count them as they slumber in their beds. So when you're worried and you can't sleep, just count your blessings instead of sheep, and you'll fall asleep. Count in your blessings. Thank you all so much for joining, and I hope that you loved Fridays with Roz. Thank you all so much. I'll see you all next time. Thank you all so much for the love. Thank you all so much. Thank you. Beautiful song. Oh, yes, later, Roz. Well, you know, I mean, I'm still here. I haven't been cut off yet. So, yes, thank you all so much for joining. I so appreciate it. Michael Ormsby, Tony Dark. Oh, simply stunning. Thank you all so much. Martin Smithson, another great show. Thank you. Listen, I told you all, we're just going to go up from here. So be sure that you catch my next live stream the weekend after next. We're going to actually take it to the country. And we're going to have some friends, maybe some Patsy Cline, Miss Loretta Lynn, because I have to represent my country girls. So, Miss Kinsey George! I'm so glad you were on here. Thank you so much. And yes, thank you for joining, and please remember, invite your friends to love our page, and I think that's all she wrote. So let's go out, Miss Lola.